In Windows, there are several folders that have very special, unique purposes that can be pretty useful that you'll definitely want to know about. And since it's a lot easier to just show you what I mean, I'm not going to keep you waiting. I'm Theo Joe, and let's jump into it. For some very quick context, most of these folders can be opened with so-called shell shortcuts, like this first one I can talk about, the startup folder, which can be accessed by going into the file explorer and just hitting shell startup, or you could also type this into the run box. This will take you to the actual file path for this special startup folder, and what this one does is any shortcuts in here will be automatically run when Windows starts, when you log in. Now, this folder is specific to the current user, but there is another startup folder which can be accessed by doing shell common startup, and this one contains shortcuts that will be started no matter what user is logging into the computer. It's for all users. I don't think I need to explain why this would be useful. If you have a program or even something like a batch script that you want to run when Windows starts, you can simply put it in this folder and it will. So definitely a good one to know about. Next, another special folder we can talk about is for the start menu. And you can access this by simply typing in shell programs. And in this folder, if you weren't already aware, this is where the all apps list from the start menu gets its list. Anything in here will show up in the start menu. Again, this particular folder is just for the current user, but there is another one for all users, and you can get to that by going to shell common programs, and that goes to this path. Now, you might be wondering how this is actually going to be useful to you, and here are some tips. Say you want an item to appear near the top of the start menu. You can simply add an exclamation point to it, which appears high up alphabetically, and then it'll appear at the top. So maybe you use it often enough where you want it at the top, but not enough to actually pin it to the main start menu. Also, you might want to remove items from the start menu list, and in that case, you just delete the shortcut. If you want, you can also organize the items into their own folders. So maybe you want all the Microsoft Office programs to be in the same folder instead of just all separated like they are by default, at least for me. However, there are a couple things I want to point out that I discovered. First of all, if you have two shortcuts that go to the same thing, only one of them will show up even if the two shortcuts are named differently. And this also applies even if one of the duplicates is in a folder and one is not. Still, only one will show up. I also noticed if you create a folder but only put one shortcut in it, it will basically ignore the folder and just put that shortcut in the main list as if there was no folder at all. All right, moving on, this one's actually a bit more interesting, and it is the apps folder, which can be accessed by doing shell apps folder, no spaces. Now, this one is a virtual folder. It doesn't actually go to a real directory. And from my understanding, this will show shortcuts to all apps that are installed. And again, this has a use that you might not have thought of. I personally have found this folder useful for creating shortcuts in certain circumstances, specifically when it comes to apps installed from the Microsoft Store. For example, maybe I want to create a desktop shortcut for this app, Power Automate, but for whatever reason, it doesn't appear in the Start Menu Apps list. Otherwise, I could just drag it from the All Apps list onto the desktop. And also, for some bizarre reason, in Windows 11, you can't create a shortcut from the search results or even drag it from there. You can only pin it to the taskbar or start menu. And no, you can't drag it off the pinned start menu or taskbar either. So how do you create a shortcut? And even further, it is a so-called UWP app, which basically means it's from the Microsoft Store and is installed differently. So you can't even just access the installation folder. It's inside a protected directory called Windows Apps, and you can't even access it as administrator. But what you can do is in this apps folder, you will find this because it basically lists all installed apps. And then you can right click it here and hit create shortcut, and it will go to the desktop. And you'll notice if you go to the properties of that shortcut, it doesn't even go to a directory. It just points to the reference of the app. So again, that goes back to where I mentioned it's not installed in a normal way. So yeah, the apps folder is a bit interesting. I don't know if there's any other use cases for it, but at least good to know about. All right, next up we have the send to folder, which can be accessed by doing shell send to, and that goes to this directory. And for this folder, any shortcuts you add here will actually show up when you right-click a file and go to send to. And you'll notice the default items in here already are not just normal shortcuts. Like if you go to properties for the zip folder, the file type is ZF send to target, and the desktop one is a desk link file. However, you can actually put regular shortcuts in here to apps. And if you use a file with that send to entry to that app, it seems to behave the same as if you had dragged that file onto the program with another shortcut. And this can actually be useful in a couple ways. For example, maybe as an alternative to the open with right-click option. Say you often deal with image files, and you usually have to open them in different image editing programs like maybe Photoshop and Inkscape. But if you go to right-click an image file and open with, those programs aren't even there, and it's a pain if you have to open the list of more apps every time. And you don't want to change the default app because you still want it to open with the photo viewer, and you open it with multiple programs anyway. Instead, what you could do is create shortcuts to those apps in the send to folder, and then use that to open the files with those programs anytime you need. If you're a bit more advanced, you can even create a shortcut to a batch file that you've created to process files in some way. Though also with a batch file, if you're going to use it with the send to, you have to make sure that you code it in a way where it works from dragging files onto it, and then it'll work with the send to. Moving on, we have the fonts folder, which you can get to through shell fonts or just C Windows fonts. And you'll notice this folder also has a unique interface for handling all the installed fonts on the system. Here you can do stuff like previewing fonts, what they look like at different sizes. You can also delete fonts from the computer altogether, or you can right click and hide them so it doesn't show in the fonts list when you use a program like Microsoft Word or something. And then if you want to show them again, you can also do that and even sort by the hidden ones to find those easily. You can also sort them from a bunch of other qualities like their purpose and, you know, the design or stuff like that that you might be interested in. I will point out though that there is another location to manage fonts through the settings, personalization, and then fonts menu. And you can do a lot of the similar stuff here, but not quite as much. All right, now this next folder is not actually a shell shortcut folder, but still pretty important. And that is the taskbar pinned folder. You'll just have to navigate to this folder yourself at this location, but any shortcuts in here should appear in the taskbar at the bottom. However, similar to the start menu, any duplicates also seem to not appear here. This could be useful if maybe you want to change the launch parameters of a shortcut, like through the properties target box, that could come in handy, or maybe you want to change the icon of one of the shortcuts for how it appears. I've also had it come in handy in the past where there was a bugged out item in the taskbar where I couldn't delete it, but I went to this folder and was able to delete it from in there. All right, now finally, I want to mention that there are many other special folders in Windows, but not too many of them are very interesting. There is an app called Nearsoft's Special Folder View that you can use to look at these. But again, the other ones are less interesting, even though they're technically special, literally being part of the Windows Constant Special Items list, it's called. And these include things like the Desktop folder and the Program Files folder that we all already know about. But I will put a link to that app in the description if you want to check it out yourself and maybe look through this. Anyway, let me know down in the comments if you knew about these folders, or maybe you didn't, but still learned some of those tips. And also let me know if there's any tips of your own that I did not mention. In any case, if you did enjoy this video, definitely give it a big giant thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm, and maybe consider subscribing. I try to make videos about twice a week, usually Wednesday and Saturday. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about some more advanced Windows features that you'll probably want to know about that not everyone does. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.